Do you want to grow your chest without using any weights or the gym? Then this is the perfect video to watch, because I'm gonna show you my favorite chest routine to get a big and strong chest. So let's get started. What's up guys, it's Jannik here and we are here at the beautiful park in the Netherlands. So today I'm going to give you my favorite chest exercises to get a big chest. So in the past 3 or 4 years I've been doing bodyweight exercises only, and before this time I went to the gym, so I did a lot of like bench press and flies to grow my chest. But I wanted to switch over to calisthenics, but I was afraid actually that I wasn't able to build muscle mass with bodyweight exercises. But now after 4 years of bodyweight training only, I can only say that I still got a lot of chest gains with the right routine. So today I'm gonna give you the perfect routine to get a big chest. All right, so today we're gonna do 6 exercises in total, and we're gonna work in hypertrophy rep range. So that means 8 to 12 repetitions, which is the optimal amount to grow your chest. So for each exercise today, I'm going to give you the exact amount of repetitions that you need to do, and I'm also going to give you a progression. So if the exercise is easier, you can move on to a harder variation. So let's get started with the first exercise, which is the wide push-ups. Alright, so for the wide push-up, we're going to work the outer side of your chest. So for this exercise, you're only going to need the floor, and you're going to have a wide stand with your hands. You're going to twist your hands a little bit outside. From here you're going to do push-ups with your chest all the way to the floor. So if this variation is a little bit too easy for you, you can also move on to the archer push-up, which is a unilateral exercise, which is basically a assisted one-arm push-up. And with this variation, it is really important that you always keep one arm completely straight. So all the stress is going to be on one chest only. So for both variations, you want to do 8 repetitions for 4 sets. So when you're done with the first exercise, we're going to move on to the second exercise, which is the Hindu push-up. So with the Hindu push-up, you're going to target the upper side and the lower side of your chest, because this exercise basically consists out of 2 parts. You're going to start in a downward facing dog, and from here you're going to move your head forward, and at the end you're going to push yourself up into the upward facing dog. From here you're going to do the same movement backwards, and this is 1 repetition. So make sure to do 8 repetitions in total for 4 sets. And if this exercise is too easy, you can also move on to a harder progression, and this is going to be the pseudo push-up, or also known as the forward lean push-up. So from here you're going to start in a push-up position, then you're going to lean forward, and from here you're going to push yourself up. And the goal is at the end to have your hands at your waistline. From here, keep your scapula protracted and push up and down. So this is really a good exercise for the lower chest as well, and also for the shoulders. So for both exercises, take about 90 seconds of rest, do 4 sets in total, and then we're going to move on to the 3rd exercise. So the 3rd exercise is the explosive push-up. And you're going to target the whole chest, but you're also going to target the muscles in a different way. Because this is an explosive exercise, you're going to work the fast twitch muscle fibers, which will force the muscles to grow even faster. So the first variation is the explosive push-up. So you're going to start in a push-up position, but instead of just doing regular push-up, you're going to press a little bit harder and try to get off the ground with your hands. So you want to do this for 8 repetitions in total. So if this is too easy for you and you're up for a little bit more challenge, you can do clapping push-up. It basically is the same exercise, but now you're going to press even harder and make a clap in between each push-up. So 8 reps in total for 4 sets, and also take 90 seconds of rest, and then you're ready for the next exercise. So the next exercise is the diamond push-up. And with this exercise, you're really going to feel the inner side of your chest. So basically, you're going to start in a push-up position, make a triangle with your hands, so a small grip. From here, you're going to move your chest towards your hand and push up. So this is really going to target the inner side of your chest. So for this exercise, you want to do 12 repetitions in total for 4 sets. So if this exercise is too easy for you, you can make it harder by using an elevation for your feet, so you're going to have more pressure on your hands and chest. So for this exercise, you want to take 60 seconds of rest after each set. And when you're done with 4 sets, you're going to move on to the 5th exercise. All right, so the 5th exercise is the bench dip. With this exercise, you're going to target the lower chest and also a part of your shoulders. So for this exercise, you're going to need an elevation and you're going to have a pretty wide grip. So with this grip, you're going to target the chest even more. So you're going to stand on the elevation with your hands and you're going to have straight legs. And from here, you're going to do dips until your elbows are in a 90 degree angle. So for this exercise, you want to do 12 repetitions in total for 4 sets. So if this exercise gets too easy, you can move on to the parallel dip. So for this exercise, you need parallel bars, but you can also do this exercise on rings if you want to work on your stabilization muscles as well. So you're going to start on parallel bars and you want to make sure to keep your elbows inwards while doing the dip. And you want to move down until you have a 90 degree angle in your elbows and you want to push up again. So if you find the gap between the bench dip and the parallel dip a little bit too hard, you can also make it easier by using an assistance band. You can start with a thick band, for example, and then move on to a thin band until you're strong enough to do the parallel dip without a band. So that was the 5th exercise. So now let's move on to the last exercise, which is the decline push-up. So for this exercise, we're gonna work the upper side of our chest. And for this exercise, we're gonna need an elevation where you're gonna stand on with your feet. And from here, you're gonna stand in a push-up position and move your chest towards the floor. So this exercise, we're gonna do 12 repetitions as well for 4 sets. And if the regular decline push-up is too easy for you, you can make this harder actually by using a resistance band. You can use this by bringing it around your back and sticking it underneath your hands, so you actually get more resistance when doing the push-up. You can basically apply this method with any push-up to make it harder. All right, so that's it. 6 of my favorite exercises that I used in the past 4 years to get a strong and big chest. So I will add a full overview of the full workout, including sets, reps, and rest times into the screen, so you can take a screenshot and take the workout with you towards the park. So if you want to bring your workouts to the next level, we offer different programs with different goals. So if you want to learn skills, get muscle mass, lose weight, or train at home with your body weight, check out the links in the description. So that's it for this video. Please put your thumbs up, subscribe, and we see you in the next video. Peace out.